Hello, VC. And hello, Mike. The Aural Retentive. That's really, really hard to say. Cheers. Nice ice cold beer, as I always like to have when I'm making a video. Well, hello, Mike, and the Aural Retentive. That's really, really hard. You are having a 100 subscribers contest. Congratulations with that, Mike. I think you have been around for almost 2 years now. So you should definitely have more than 100 subscribers. But what the hell? You are here now and have 100 subscribers. Cheers again. And you are having a contest as well, which is the first time I have seen this in the VC. It's the 1, 2, 3 box set, which is first show and album. I don't know if it's only CDs or vinyl, but whatever. But show an album with just one disc, and then an album with 2 discs, 3 discs, 4 discs, 5 discs, 6 discs, and let's see how far you get. So yeah, I found something that I would like to show. It's pretty hard. You're also supposed to tell a story of every album or every item. So let's see how far we get. I don't really have that huge a story for everything, but let's just say a little short story would be enough, maybe. So let's get started. The first album, which is just one single disc in an album, that was actually the hardest thing to do, because when you have around 2000 albums, how do you just pick one? So I thought, what can I show? I could show a Prince album, but you already know that I like him, and I could show an album that I've gotten at VCLC, but I've gotten so many, then I couldn't really decide what to pick, so what the hell to choose? So I simply just chose, because this is a special pressing, thick as a brick, pretty good condition as well. And the reason that I am showing this, is, oh my god, I have to close it the right way. The reason I am going to show this is simply because it's a Danish pressing. You don't see a Danish pressing every day, and I believe that you guys from the US and other places don't see a Danish pressing too often, so let's see if we can get it to focus on the label there, so you can see it's a made in Denmark. Pretty cool. I hope you could see that. Even I, who live in Denmark, don't have a whole lot Danish pressing. We did have some Danish pressing plants back in the 70s and 80s, but even though we had that, I don't have a lot of Danish pressings. I also have a couple of Beatles Danish pressings, which is kind of great as well. But yeah, Jethro Tull, thick as a brick, a Danish pressing, is my single disc item. Not that much of a story connected to that, but hey. The next one, the 2-disc set, is by my favorite Danish singer and songwriter, Allan Olsen. pretty nice cover, as you can see it's kind of embossed somewhere, and it's also signed by Allan Olsen himself. This is a twofer, if you can say it like that. The first album is his new album, if you can say it like that, Hudsult, and this is all Danish, but that's the normal album, and the second disc is a live album from his previous tour, and as you can see, the back is black like that, also embossed, and it's kind of cool the whole way through. Also, the inner sleeves there has this pattern, and also the label there has this same pattern, so it's custom labels all the way through, and the second disc is just black, just like the back cover. And I have met Allan Olsen at a concert. I saw him at a really small venue, which actually was a cinema, and we found out that Allan was sitting in the back, so I thought I would try to walk up there and knock on the door and ask if I could get an autograph, and I could, and he was a nice guy. He was sitting and having a cognac, I think, and I asked him if I could get his autograph, and yeah, sure. And then I said that I have seen him a couple of times on this tour, and then he said, "Oh shit, then you know everything I'm going to say." And I said, "Yeah, well, that's fine. I would like it anyway." So that's kind of a funny story. Another story, as I was shopping in my local, not shopping center, grocery store, I kind of walked through the wine department, and then suddenly I saw something that really looked familiar to me. And then I looked at the label, and it kind of looked like this cover. I will show it right here so you can see it. So apparently Allan have got his inspiration for this cover from this French fine wine, I think. So, and probably Allan Olsen is kind of a fine musician, aged well. So that was the two disc set. Oh my god, cheers again. This is turning out to be a little bit longer video than I thought it would be. For the three disc set, I choose to show this DAD compilation. This was released when DAD, maybe I should tell you for those that don't know DAD, DAD is a Danish heavy metal band that have been around for more than 30 years, because this is their 30 year anniversary compilation release celebration, if you can say it like that. And as you can probably see, before they were called DAD, they were called Disneyland After Dark, but of course, when Disneyland After Dark got a $1 million record contract in the US, Disney didn't like that name. So they had to change from Disneyland After Dark to DAD. And it's kind of written a little funny here, Disneyland After Dark. But yeah, this is a 3 LP set, and we have the mascot there, Molly, also on the front. But there's a disc in every sleeve, as you can see here, and a download code and stuff like that. And you can see the track listing there. A lot of great tracks on three discs. And even though this is a Danish band, this is made in the EU. But this is DAD's greatest hits on vinyl. Cheers again, Mike. I hope you're enjoying this. Now, for the next one, I was in trouble. 4 discs. That's not that normal. And I looked through my collection and I couldn't really find any. And then I remembered that it's kind of like this, the records that I don't have room for in my own collection, I store in my son's room so he can play them. And it's really soothing for him too, because at a thrift store I found this Disney storytelling album, and as you can see, it's Danish. Everything is in Danish. Also, the stories are in Danish, and it has 4 discs. This is the Jungle Book, as you can see. The cover is not that great on this one. Jungle Book and Snevide on Danish, which is, what's that? What's that in English? Snow White and the 7 Dwarfs. Is it just called that? I can't remember. But that's the second one, and then Mary Poppins, Walt Disney and Pinocchio. Should we just take a look at one of the labels just for fun? To see how it looks. They are a little bit scratched, but hey, I found it for I think I paid $2 for the whole thing, and I was kind of hoping that my son would listen to them, but he is 15 now, and when I bought them he was probably 12 or 13, but he hasn't listened to them anyway. But it's a Walt Disney stories set on 4 discs. Kind of nice. So I was lucky to get on to the 5-disc set. How many are going to get there? Let's see. And like I told Mike, this next one, there's probably a lot of people that's going to show this. And like you, Mike, I also choose to show the 5 LP set of Bruce Springsteen and the E Street Band live 1975-1985. And it's pretty good condition, this one. It has this scratch in the corner there, but everything else is really, really good, and the album as well also comes with the nice booklet there, and the great LPs in inner sleeves, and as you can see they are almost like new. A story about this is, at some point in my probably late 30s, I was hanging around with, no, not late 30s, late 20s, I was hanging around with a cousin of mine, which were a fan of Bruce Springsteen, and he played this album one day, and is it the last song? Yes, Jersey Girl. I absolutely loved that song. It was so fantastic live. And of course I had to find this album, and I bought the CD not knowing that one day when I bought a Tom Waits album, the what's this called, Heart Attack and Wine, suddenly the Jersey Girl song came was played, or what you say, I'm not that great at English, but suddenly I heard Jersey Girl and I thought Bruce wrote that, but apparently he didn't. It's a Tom Waits song, and that actually made me want to search into Tom Waits. So I bought a couple of Tom Waits albums on CD, three maybe, and I've been buying some others on CD or some others on vinyl, excuse me. And I really, really like Tom Waits now. So that's kind of a funny story to the Bruce Springsteen and EC band. No, not EC band. E Street Band and the 5 LP set. And I'm back. When I started to put these LPs back again, I actually saw that I am disqualified for this contest, because I got to look at the stories that are supposed to be on this album. The Jungle Book, Mary Poppins, Snow White, and Cinderella, and Pinocchio. The Cinderella disc is missing. I didn't know that. So this is actually supposed to be a 5 LP set. So I messed up, Mike. So, well, anyway, Mike, because you live in the US and I pretty much do this every time I enter a contest to one of you guys from the US or Australia or on the other side of the world, I'm going to say leave me out of the contest, because the shipping price is really too expensive to ship to Denmark, even though I quite like your prices. I'm going to say leave me out of the contest, and also because I'm disqualifying myself for this mess up. So that was it, Mike. I hope you liked it. Cheers, and I hope you get a lot of responses to this. I'm going to put a link below to your video with your 100 subscribers video, and let's hope that people will follow the link and visit your channel, and you will get some subscribers. Cheers again, and have a nice day, VC. Bye bye.